Hello kids, how are you all? I hope you all are fit and fine. Welcome to online classes. This side Hema Yadav from Shiv Jyoti Educational Group Kota. Children, today we will do Maths Notebook work. Chapter 1, Numbers 100 to 200. So your question 1 is, first of all you have to mention class work at the right top corner in your notebook. After that, you will write chapter 1, the name of the chapter, numbers 100 to 200. And after that, you will draw red margin as shown here. Now, question 1 is, write the place value of each digit. In this question, children, you have to write the place values of each digit. So, here, what is the number given? A part of this question is, in the numeral 135. Children, in this question you have to tell the place value of each digit in 135. So let's move on the board. First we will see how we will write the place value. So in this question, in the numeral 135, numeral means number. In number 135, first of all we will see how many digits it's have. It is having 3 digits. So, as you know children, 3 digit number we always count in hundreds. So, first we will write the place value. Place value of 1. So, we will start counting place value from the right hand side. This is 1s, 10s and 100s. So, what is the place value of 1? The place value of 1 is 100. How we will write it? 100. Then we have to tell the place value of 3. Place value of 3. Again we will count where 3 is here. This is 1s and this is 10s. So what is the place value of 3? The place value of 3 is 3 tens, and 3 tens means 30. So we have to write down 3030 like this. Below this 0 you have to write 0, and below this the second 0 we will write 3. We will write 30 like this. Okay. Now we have to tell the place value of 5. Place value of 5 is 7. As you know, we will start counting from here. This is where it is. It is at 1's place. So place value of 5 is 5. Where we will write it? We will write it here where 1's digit is coming. Below 0. So this is the answer of your question. Now we will see. In the numeral 119, we have to write the place value of each digit. So first of all, we will write the place value of this 1. Place value of 1 is, we will start counting place value of 1. This is 1, 1s, 10s and 100s. So place value of 1 is 100 here. How we will write 100? We will write 100, 100. Now place value of 1, again 1 is written here. So we have to write the place value of this 1. So we will start counting from 1's place. This is 1's and 10's. So place value of 110 is 10. 10. Clear? Now the place value of 9 is, where 9 is written? 9 is written at the 1's place. So we will write 9. Below these two zeros. Okay children, now let's see question number C part of this question. In the numeral 164, here you have to tell the place value of each digit in this numeral 164. Place value of 1 is, as you know, 1s, 10s and 100s. The place value of 1 is 100. So we will write 100. The place value of 6 is at 10th place, so six tens means 60. So we will write here 6060. And the place value of 4 is, it is where written? It is written at ones place. So we will write 4 as it is below these two zeros. I hope you have understood. Now we will see question number 2. Question number 2. Write the expanded form of the following numbers. Here few numbers are written. 114, 105. So you have to tell the expanded form of these numbers. So children, as you know, what is expanded form? Expanded form is the sum of all these place values. Okay. So first of all, what is the place value of this one? 100. So we will write 1. We can write this sum into two types. First type is 100. The base value of this one is 110, and the base value of 4 is 4 ones. Now we will add all these base values of these digits. So 100 plus 110 means 10, and 4 ones means 4. Now when we will add all these numbers, then we will get 140. Let's see next one. Now children, let's see this sum on the board. Here, expanded form. You have to write the expanded form of 140. So as you know children, I told you, expanded form is the sum of all these place value of the given digit. So what is the place value of this one? This is 100. And in other way, how can we write it? 100. And what is the place value of this one? This is 110. 110 means 10. And what is the place value of 4? Place value of 4 is 1s. So we will write 4 1s. 4 ones means 4. This is the expanded form of this number. I hope you have understood. Now let's see the next sum. This is B part of this question. Now here we have to tell the expanded form of 105. So what we will do? We will find out their place values and we will put the addition sign in between them. So place value of 1 is 100, so we will write 100. The spelling of 100 is H-U-N-D-R-E-T, 100. Now we will put the sign of addition here. Now we will write the place value of 0. 0 is written at the tens place, so we will write 0 tens. Now here we will write the place value of 5. We have to put the sign of addition here. Now we will write the place value of 5. It is 5 ones. So what will be the answer? 100 plus 0 tens means 0 plus 5 ones means 5. This is the expanded form of 105. Now question number 3 is, write the short form of the following numbers. Here you have to write the short form of the given number. The question is given in expanded form and you have to write it in short form. So what is the short form? Actually, short form is the face value of the given number. Here what is the place value of 100? It is 1. What is the face value of 5050? It is 5. And what is the place value of 3? It is 3. So children, for writing the short form, you have to write the face value of the given digits. So the number will become 153. I hope you have understood children. Now let's see the sum on the board. As I told you, what is face value? T short form. The sum is given in expanded form and here you have to write it in short form. So what are the numbers? 100 plus 50 plus 3. This is expanded form, and here you have to change it in short form. So short form is, as I told you, this is the face value of the given presence. So face value of 100 is 1. But one thing very important, children, that you have to write these digits at their correct places. 5, 10, 50 is written here. So you have to write 5 at the tens place. And 3 is given in ones. 3 is given at the ones place. So you have to write 3 at the ones place. This is the short form of this given expanded form. Now let's see next sum. Here you have to write the short form of 100 plus 7. The question is given in expanded form, and here you have to write it in short form. So children, here you can see the face value of 100 is 1, and here is no number is written at tens place, so we will write 0 at the tens place. And which number is written at ones place? 7 is written at ones place, so we will write 7 here. The number will become 107. Now let's see C part of this question. Question is given in expanded form, 100 plus 60. So again we have to write face value of these digits. The face value of 100 is 1. The face value of 60 is 6. And here there is no number is written at ones place, so we will write 0 at ones place. Okay children, I hope you have understood. Now we will see next question. Question number 4. Write what comes before, after, or between. Here you have to find out before, after, and between numbers. Children, as we told you, the after number is one more than to the given number. And before number, what is before number? Before number is one less than to the given number. And what is the between number? Between number is the number that comes in their middle. This is called between number. So let's see. First sum. One blank is given here, so dash. Then 171 is given here. So children, you have to write the before number of this 171. So as I told you, it will less than. So children, now we will see question number 4. Write what comes before, after, or between. So children, as I told you, before number is 1 less than to the given number. And what is after number? After number is 1 more than to the given number. And between number, the number which comes in the middle, it is between number. So let's see. First sum, blank is given here in A part. Then 171 is written here. So what will be the before number of 171? This will be 1 less than of the 171. So 1 less than of 171 will be 170. Clear? Now let's see B part of this. 149 and 151. Two numbers are given here. You have to find out between number of these two numbers. So as I told you, the number which is middle in both of them, this is between number. So what will come in their middle? 149, then 150 and 151. Now C part of this question is 137 is written here, and after 137 is written here, and after it blank is given. So as I told you, the after number, the one more than to the given number is called after number. So what will be one more than of 137? It will be 138, or you can say the number which comes later, just later after 137, this is 138. Now children, D part of this question. Numbers are given 184, then dash is given here, then 186 is written. So what you have to find out? You have to find out between number. So what number come in their middle? After 184, 185 will come here. Okay. Now E, 167 is written. So you have to find out before number of this 167. So as I told you, it will be 1 less than of the given number. So it is 166. F, 153 and 155 is given here, and you have to find out between number of these two numbers. So 154 will come here. Now G, 110 is written here, and after it one blank is given here, dash is given here. So you have to find out the after number of this 110. So it will be 1 more than of 110. So it is 111. H, 100 is written here, and you have to find out after number of this. So it will be 101. And in last question, 200 is written here, and you have to find out before number of this. So what is the before number of 200? It is 1 less than of 200. This is 199.
So children, now we will do question number 5. Write the ordinal numbers. So children, what are ordinal numbers? As I told you, the ordinal numbers is a kind of number name, and they show the position of things that are placed in a fixed order. So here we will see few numbers and their ordinal numbers. Number 1, what is the ordinal number of 1? This is first, and the spelling of first is F-I-R-S-T, first. This is number 2. The ordinal number of 2 is second. Spelling of second is S-E-C-O-N-D, second. Number 3. Ordinal number of 3 is third. Spelling of third is T-H-I-R-D, third. Number 4, the ordinal number of 4 is 4th. The spelling of 4th is F-O-U-R-T-H. Children, you have noticed one thing, that here we are writing the number and we are adding here S-T, N-D, R-D and T-H. Why we are adding these? Because this spelling is ending with S-T, this is ending with N-D, this is ending with RD. So we can say the sound that comes at the last, that will be added here after number. So the ordinal number of 5 is 5th, F-I-F-T-H, 5th. This is the spelling of 5th. 6, this is the ordinal number of 6, this is 6th. Spelling of 6th is S-I-X-T-H, 6th. What we will add here after 6? As I told you, we will add the ending sound of the given number. So this is the TH sound here. So we will add here TH. Okay. Now ordinal number of 7 is 7th. The spelling of 7th is S-E-V-E-N-T-H, 7th. Similarly, 8. Spelling of 8th is, the ordinal number of 8 is 8th. And spelling is E-I-G-H-T-H, 8th. 9, ordinal number of 9 is 9th. Spelling of 9th, N-I-N-T-H, 9th. Because it is also ending with T-H, so we will add here T-H again. Now, ordinal number of 10 is 10th. Spelling of 10th is T-E-N-T-H, 10th. Now, we will see from here. This is 11, and the ordinal number of 11 is 11th. Spelling of it, E-L-E-V-E-N-T-H, 11th. Okay. Now, what we are doing here? We are adding T-H after the spelling of 11. And it is ending with T-H, so we will add here T-H in 11. Okay. Now, ordinal number of 12 is 12th. And what will be the spelling? It is exception. We will not add TH here. The spelling of 12th is, we will add here F, then after F, TH. So spelling of 12th is T-W-E-L-F-T-H, 12th. 13, ordinal number is 13th, spelling is T-H-I-R-T-E-E-N-T-H. What we are doing here, we are first writing the spelling of 13, then after it we are adding th. Same here also, spelling of ordinal number of 14 is 14th, spelling of 14th is f-o-u-r-t-e-e-n-t-h 14th. 15, ordinal number is 15th, spelling is s-f-i-f-t-e-e-n-t-h 15th. 16, spelling of 16th is s-i-x-t-e-e-n-t-h 16th. We are writing the spelling of 16 and we are adding after that th. Okay, now 17, ordinal number is 17th, spelling is s-e-v-e-n-t-e-e-n-t-h 17th. 18, ordinal number is 18th. Spelling of 18th is, first we will write the spelling of 18, then we will add after it th. So spelling is e-i-g-h-t-e-e-n-t-h 18th. Now 19, ordinal number is 19th. Spelling of 19th is, first we will write the spelling of 19, and we will add here th 19th. And the spelling and the ordinal number of 20 is 20th. So how we will write the spelling of 20th? We will remove y from the spelling of 20, then we will add I, E instead of y, then we will put th after I, E. So what will be the spelling? T, W, E, N, T, I, E, T, H, 20th. What we have done here, we remove y from the spelling of 20, then add ie, and after ie we will write th. Now let's move further. This is number 21, and what is the ordinal number of 21? This is 21st. So first of all we will write the spelling of 20, then we will add, instead of writing 1 here, we will write first. And you know what is the spelling of first? We have done previously this one. So what is the ordinal number of 21 is 21st. Now 22, ordinal number of 22 is 22nd. And what is the spelling of 22nd? T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20. And you will write the spelling of second, as you know, S-E-C-O-N-D. And here what we will add after 22, we will add N-D because it is ending with the sound of N-D. Okay. Now 23, ordinal number of 23 is 23rd. Spelling of 23rd is T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20. T-H-I-R-D, 3rd. 24, ordinal number is 24th. Spelling is T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20, F-O-U-R-T-H, 4. Okay children, I hope you all have understood what we are doing here. We are writing first the spelling of 20, then we are adding first, second, third. Okay. Now 25, ordinal number of 25 is 25th. Spelling is T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20, F-I-F-T-H, 5th. This is 26, ordinal number is 26th, spelling is T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20, S-I-X-T-S, 6th. 27, ordinal number is 27th, spelling is T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20, S-E-V-E-N-T-S, 7th. 27th, 28, ordinal number is 28th. Spelling is T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20, E-I-G-H-T-H, 8th, 28th. Now 29, ordinal number is 29th, spelling is T-W-E-N-T-Y, 20, N-I-N-T-H, 9th. Now 30, ordinal number is 30th. And how we will write the spelling? We will remove Y from the spelling of 30, then we will write R-E instead of Y, then add T-H. This is 30th. Now further, how can we write? We can add first after the spelling of 30. So what it will become? It will become 31st. I hope you have understood.
We'll see question number 6 and circle the even numbers. Children, as you know, what are even numbers? The numbers which end with 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 are called even numbers. So here you have to find out those numbers which are ending with 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Here in this number, this is not ending with all these numbers, it is ending with 7, so this is not even number. This is also not even number because it is not ending with 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. This is also not ending with these numbers, and here you can see 192 is ending with 2, so this is even number. In B, this number is 107. So it is not ending with 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. 114, this is ending with 4. So this is even, this is an even number. In these two numbers, these both are ending with 7 and 3. So they both are not even number. Now see, 110, 139, 163 and 177 are written here. So we have to find out which number is ending with 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Here, this number is ending with 0, so this is an even number. I hope you have understood. Now we will see question number 7 and circle the odd numbers. And what are odd numbers, children? Odd numbers always ends with 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9. So here we have to find out these numbers 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9. So in A, numbers are written 132, 128, 191 and so children, this is 152. Here we have to find out which number is ending with 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9. Here children, you can see this number is ending with 1, so this is an odd number. As you know, what numbers will come at the end of an odd number? 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9. Here, B part of this question, this is 148, this is 156, 134 and 179. This number is ending with 1, line is coming here. So this is an odd number. Here, C part of this, 112, 145, 118 and 124. These numbers are given here. So again you have to find out an odd number. So this number is ending with 5. So this is an odd number. So children, I hope you have understood this chapter very well, this notebook work very well. Now do this work in very beautiful handwriting.